Hello, welcome to the step-by-step instructional video on how to prove the cosine rule. So let's get stuck right in. Okay, so we're going to make use of this diagram, but the first thing we're going to do, as always in our proofs, guys, is that we need to write down what we're actually trying to prove, okay? So that's our first step. So it's going to look like this. So to prove the cosine rule, which is that a squared equals b squared plus c squared minus 2bc cos of a. Now what is this rule actually telling us? Have a look at your diagram on the left hand side here, guys. If you have a triangle like this, okay, and let's say you're trying to find the length of this side of the triangle labeled a, then as long as we know what the angle is opposite to a, it has to be opposite though, as long as we know the angle opposite to a and we know the two other sides, then we can find a using this cosine rule, okay? And that's why it's quite useful. So let's go ahead with the construction part of our proof. So construct a line. So construct a line CD, let's call it H, just to make things simpler, okay, called H, perpendicular to AB such that AD is equal to X and DB is equal to C minus X. Now this is going to make a lot more sense when I actually draw the diagram for you, okay? So guys, let's do our perpendicular line first, okay? So it's saying it wants a line CD, so it wants to point through the point C, through the vertex C, and it wants a perpendicular to AB. Now guys, I always do my constructions in a dotted line. I think it's best if you do that too, because it really points out to the examiner or to whoever is reading your proof that this is the construction part, okay? This is not just the given context. And there's a dotted line, okay? So it's a perpendicular line, so straight away we can mark in our right angles. Okay, perpendicular meaning at 90 degrees too. And we're going to mark this as the point D. Okay, so this is now CD, which we said we're going to call H. So we've also said they want to do it such that AD, this distance, is equal to some X. This is equal to X. And that DB is equal to C minus X. Now that makes sense, just because if we're going to call this distance X, the whole distance is C, so the leftover bit must be C minus X, okay? Good. Now guys, to do this proof, what we're going to do now is, if you have a look here, by doing this perpendicular line, I've really split this big triangle into two smaller ones, essentially. So we've got our triangle ACD, and we also have our triangle CDB. And if you have a look here, I already have prepared a couple. So I just wanted you to pause the video here and let's see now if you can label all the sides and angles we have here onto our two separate triangles here. See how you get on with that. Okay, so we have on this left-hand triangle, this is A, C, this is C, sorry, this is C, this is D. This was our length H, this is now length X. We also have that this is angle A, and we have that this length of the side is labeled as B. Okay, similarly in the right hand triangle, this is as the vertex D, B, C. We have that this is a length C minus X, this is H as we labeled it before, and this is the side A, okay? We can also mark in our right angles, guys. Now we've got two right angled triangles here. So that means that for our proof, guys, we can go ahead and use Pythagoras' theorem. So let's go ahead with our proof. Okay. Applying Pythagoras' theorem So in triangle ACD, we have the following. That B squared is equal to X squared plus H squared. And this is just Pythagoras' theorem, guys, which is, remember that the hypotenuse, the side opposite the right angle squared, is equal to the other two sides squared added together, essentially. So the side that's opposite the hypotenuse, square that, and that's equal to the other two sides squared. Now, I want to simplify this down so that we have h equals something, okay? I want to make h the subject. Okay, so to do that, I'm going to have b squared minus x squared is equal to h squared. Perfect. Okay, now let's draw our attention to CDB, again, using Pythagoras' theorem. So now we have in triangle CDB, the hypotenuse this time is a squared. So we have that a squared is equal to c minus x squared plus h squared. Again, let's try to make h the subject. So we end up with a squared minus c minus x squared is equal to h squared. Now, guys, what can we do? Well, we can equate these. They're both equal to h squared. So now we can let b minus x squared equal a squared minus c minus x all squared. Okay. Now, I want you to try and go ahead now, pause the video, and let those two equal to each other, do some algebra, and try simplifying down to something that's going to make a bit more sense and look a bit more like the cosine rule. Okay, so equating these two now, what do we find? We find that b squared minus x squared is equal to a squared minus c minus x all squared. Now let's multiply out this bracket on the right here. So we've got b squared minus x squared equals a squared minus c squared minus 2cx plus x squared. That's just me multiplying out the bracket, okay? Now let's get rid of these brackets, okay? Multiply this minus sign through. So we end up with b squared minus x squared is equal to a squared minus c squared plus 2cx minus x squared. Now we've got a minus x squared on this side, which cancels with our minus x squared on this side. Lovely. Now, let's try to put a squared on one side, because this is looking more and more like our cosine rule, right? We have our a squared, we've got a b squared, we've got a c squared, but on our cosine rule, we've got an a squared on one side and everything else on the other side. So let's do that and see if it takes us any closer. So let's take everything over. We have b squared plus c squared minus c squared becomes plus c squared. Plus 2cx becomes minus 2cx. And that's all equal to a squared. Okay, getting closer and closer here. But this x here, what is this x actually? Let's have a look. Let's go back to our triangle here. I'm just going to take this down with us. Okay. So, well, we can write x in terms of the angle A and in terms of B. We can do that using the cos formula. So we have the cos of A in any right angle triangle, okay, is equal to the adjacent side of the right angle triangle over the hypotenuse. So let's label the sides of this right angle triangle with opposite, adjacent, and hypotenuse, okay? The opposite is always whatever is opposite the angle. So in this case, this is h. The hypotenuse is always whatever is opposite the right angle. So in this case, it's b, it's hypotenuse. And finally, the adjacent is whatever the remaining side is, which is x. So on our cos formula, what does that give us? And cos A is equal to x over the hypotenuse, which is b. Okay. So now we have the cos A is equal to x over b. So let's get x on its own. I'm going to multiply both sides by b. Doesn't change anything. Cancel our b. We end up with b cos A is equal to x. Okay, so now subbing this value for x back into our previous formula, which we found before, which was that b squared plus c squared minus 2cx was equal to a squared. Okay, let's just copy that down here. Now we have that x is equal to b cos of a, so let's just sub that in. We end up with b squared plus c squared minus 2c by b cos a equals a squared. And now, guys, with a very little bit of rearranging, we end up with our cos rule, which is just that a squared is equal to b squared plus c squared minus 2bc cos a. Here I've just changed the order of what's on the right and left of the equal sign, which is a perfectly valid thing to do. And I've switched around the order of b and c because they're multiplied together. It can b times c is equal to c times b. I've turned them around to look like something more familiar and to look exactly at the cos rule that we know and love and use from our log tables. So we're done.